In recent years, we often extend our focus to what lies beyond the solar system. After the Voyager probes did their flyby of the gas giants, astronomers thought that they had found everything that existed in our local system. Though we can see billions of light years into space, there are still objects hidden from view right under our noses. The Kuiper Belt, the ring of objects beyond Neptune, had been predicted to exist in 1951, but was only proven in 1992. Something that appeared close against the background of stars actually took 40 years to find. But beyond the belt could lie an even larger object. Planet 9, also known as Planet X, is a mysterious object that has been discussed for centuries after the discovery of Neptune. If there are 8 planets, then why not more? Why can't there be more planets out there waiting to be found? The answers may not be found in Planet 9, but other objects that lie beyond the solar system. So let's begin the search for Planet 9. Perhaps one of the most important discoveries in astronomy was the planet Neptune. Though it is not every day that you discover a new planet in the solar system, it was important for a different reason. It wasn't actually discovered, but predicted. How did they do this? Uranus was the key. Analysis of Uranus's orbit showed that there was a discrepancy between its predicted position and its actual position. Astronomers concluded that a large celestial body must be pulling Uranus from its usual orbit around the Sun, and that it could only have been a planet, nothing else was big enough. Using this technique, in 1846, astronomers Urban Le Verrier and John Couch Adams both independently predicted where the planet should be, and within a single night it was found. What if this could be used to find more planets? The first exoplanet was discovered using a similar procedure, by observing the gravitational effect on its host star. This is known as the radial velocity method. As the planet orbits the star, it pulls on it slightly, causing the star to wobble around in a circle. By detecting the slight Doppler shifts as the star moves, astronomers can work out if there is an exoplanet in that system, and how much force it is exerting on the star. Now you're probably thinking, how does discovering Neptune and exoplanets have anything to do with Planet 9? Well, these two situations both show how a planet can be found without actually seeing it through a telescope. Astronomers can locate planets based on their gravitational effects on the other known objects in the area that have already been discovered. They can then work backwards and search the skies in the general location where the planet should be. So how does this relate to Planet 9? Recently, scientists found something strange in the Kuiper Belt. 6 small objects, known as extreme trans-neptunian objects, or ETNOs, could hold the key to finding Planet 9. These objects are ridiculously far out, and take around 4,000 years to orbit the Sun. These orbits all follow a similar pattern. They orbit in the same plane, and their orbits are tilted 20 degrees relative to the solar system. Not only that, they are highly elliptical, and they all orbit in the same direction. Computer simulations tell us that there is only a 0.007% chance of this happening, or 1 in 140,000. There is actually a greater chance of the astronomers' data being wrong than for these 6 objects to line up. This led scientists back to the only possible explanation, that there is a mysterious planet pulling all of these objects onto a similar course. So here's what we know about Planet 9, if it exists. The planet orbits on the opposite side of the solar system to the clustered ETNOs, and has a highly elliptical orbit. This orbit is around 400 to 800 astronomical units from the Sun. An astronomical unit is the distance that Earth orbits the Sun, or 150 million kilometers. For another reference, this planet orbits at least 13 times that of Neptune's orbit, and takes the planet up to 20,000 years to complete. Its orbit would be 15 to 25 degrees to the plane of Earth's orbit, similar to the other ETNOs. Its diameter is about 2 to 4 times that of Earth's, are about 30,000 kilometers wide, which would make it the fifth largest planet in the solar system between Earth and Neptune. These values have been attained from the data that the clustered objects gave us, and are only rough estimates. Much like the technique used to discover Neptune and exoplanets, the tactics being used to find Planet 9 actually involve observing its gravitational effects on other bodies. But that isn't really satisfying. We usually don't think something's real until we've seen it for ourselves. The problem is that Planet 9 would be extremely dim against the background of stars, and unless we knew precisely where it was in the sky, it would be a struggle to identify. Because of its orbit, it could well be beyond the solar system, and might not return for thousands of years. Another way of observing the planet is through the radiation that it emits. This radiation probably consists of microwaves and infrared waves, so it could more easily be seen through telescopes sensitive to these wavelengths. The upcoming James Webb telescope, which is planned to be launched in 2021, will probably be able to find the dim radiation that is emitted from the planet. What amazes me about Planet 9 is how elusive it is. Though the planet should be easily found based on the general location like Neptune was, this isn't the case. Our modern technology can find distant galaxies, take pictures of black holes, and detect even the smallest of radiation bursts, but is not able to find a planet within our own solar system. The sheer distance that Planet 9 orbits at is just too far, and we won't be able to find it unless we know its exact location. Although Planet 9 has not been proven to exist, I believe there is a good chance it does. Given the minute chance that those objects could orbit on a similar path, is proof enough that something is out there waiting to be found. And so, the search for Planet 9 will continue well into the future.